Hello and welcome. My name's George and my channel's all about helping you get the most out of Logic Pro so that you can record and produce your best music in your home studio. Today we're going to be looking at the pitch correction plugin, which is bundled in the Logic Pro. And as the name suggests, this is just a quick and easy way that we can apply some pitch correction to our vocals. So let's dive in and I'll show you exactly how it all works. Okay, so I have my Logic project here with my vocal and my track right below it. And first off, I'll just play some of this vocal so you can hear what that sounds like without any pitch correction. Oh, I never meant to hurt you, never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you, should have known we were wrong right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong right from the So she's a great singer and it sounds pretty good to begin with. There's just a few little parts in particular right here. The wrong right from the is just a little bit pitchy and same thing here. Yeah, we were wrong right from the. So we're going to use the pitch correction plugin to try and help that out a little bit. So all we got to do is go over to our vocal track here. And under audio effects, click there, and we're going to go down to pitch, pitch correction, and mono. And that brings up our pitch correction plugin. Now, if I go ahead and press play, over here where you see correction, you'll be able to see where the plugin is pushing each pitch. So I'll go ahead and press play and you can have a look here and see how the plugin is reacting with the vocal currently. Oh, I never meant to hurt you, never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you, should have known we were wrong right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong right from the start. So you can see there where it's kind of pushing the vocal a little bit. Now, right off the bat, it's kind of helped in some places and not so much in some others. So there's a few parameters that we want to adjust here to help this out a little bit. So the first thing is to tell the plugin what notes we want it to actually correct and where we want it to push those notes. Because right now, if we look at this little keyboard here, you'll notice all of these notes are in blue. So effectively, the plugin's going to use every note of the scale. So in that case, you might get the singer landing on a note that's not actually in the scale of the song, the key that we're using. When we have it set up this way, the pitch correction plugin is just going to push the vocal to the closest pitch. So for example, if the singer is closest to an F, well, that's where the pitch correction plugin is going to direct that note to, regardless if that note is in the scale or not of the song that we have. So it helps to know what key your song is in, or at least know the pitches that you're trying to hit. In our case, that one part that I was talking about, no, we were wrong right from the. That wrong right from the. I have my piano pulled up here. I want the notes B flat, G, F, E flat. So, or A sharp, same as B flat. So that note, that note, that note, that note. So right now I actually turned off those notes. That's not what I want to do. But if I know that I don't need that F sharp or that C sharp, I can turn those off, for example. But if I know the actual scale, I can go over here and set the root note of the scale, which would be the note that the scale is based off. So in my case, it's going to be C. And then the scale or chord, this song is in C minor and natural minor. So natural minor scale. So now you can see that it grayed out all the notes that are not in that scale. Now we also have the option of bypassing notes. So when we bypass notes, these notes are still in the scale, but if our singer hits any of these notes, then the pitch correction is just going to do nothing. So it just won't affect the vocal. It's not going to push it to another note. Whereas if I were to edit the scale and turn these notes off, if the singer hit an F, for example, then it would probably push it down to this D sharp. Now the show pitch here, this is just to show us when we press play. It'll either show the input pitch, what the singer is actually singing, or we can see the output pitch of where the pitch correction is placing those notes. So I'll just press play and you'll be able to see kind of that little dot bouncing around. Oh, I never meant to hurt you. Never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you. Should have known we were wrong right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong right from the start. Oh, now you're running away with my heart. So that's sounding a lot better already. Now, you probably noticed when I was on input, it was showing these E's a little bit. And then when I was set to output, it would no longer land on the E because the pitch correction is doing its job and pushing it to one of these other notes that should be sung. Now, there's just a few other parameters we can tweak. This natural pitch detection, you generally want to leave that on. That just allows the plugin to naturally detect the range of the voice. If you're pitching an instrument in a very low range, such as a bass, then you might consider turning this off and switching the pitch range to low. But for most vocals and most things you'd probably use the pitch correction for, you can just use the default pitch detection on. Now the response time, so this is going to change how quickly the pitch correction gets to the corrected pitch. And if we turn this all the way down to zero, then things are going to get there a lot quicker and you're going to get this really auto-tune effect. You'll probably recognize this effect in a lot of pop tunes and it might be something that you're going after as well. So that'll sound like this. I never meant to hurt you. Never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you. Should have known we were wrong right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong right from the start. Oh, now you're running away with my heart. Now you're running away with my heart. Running away. So there you go. That might be something that you're after. But if it's not, then you can increase this response. And the higher you go, the kind of more natural it's going to sound. So you can listen back and kind of adjust that to taste. Now the tolerance, this is going to come into play with things like vibrato. So in a lot of instances, singers will apply vibrato, which actually changes the pitch of their voice up and down, especially on kind of longer held notes. So if you don't want those notes to be affected as much, then you can raise this tolerance up. And that kind of increases the range of the pitch that Logic is going to allow before it starts correcting it. So for example, I'm just going to bypass the plugin and I'll play back a little bit. You'll be able to hear some of that vibrato on the longer notes. I never meant to hurt you. So on You, for example, there's a little bit of a quiver vibrato there. Now if we turn the tolerance down, that'll kind of flatten that out a little bit. Meant to hurt you. Never meant. But if we bring this up, then we'll get a little bit of that vibrato back. Meant to hurt you. Never meant to keep you in the dark. I never meant to hurt you. Should have known we were wrong right from the start. Oh, oh, oh. Yeah, we were wrong right from the start. Oh, now you're running away with my heart. Now you're running away with my heart. Great, so that's sounding really nice, and I'm happy with that. The last two options we have here is the global tuning, which you generally want to leave on, and then the detune. This is just kind of a global tuning. So if you just wanted to pitch everything up or down, you could use this. So if I bring this down, now everything will sound a little bit flat. Oh, I never meant to hurt you. Or we can make everything a little bit sharp. I never meant to hurt you. But of course, that's not what we want. We'll just put that back right in the middle. So I hope you found that helpful, especially if you have a vocal that just needs a little bit of help, then the pitch correction plugin can hopefully do that for you. By just changing a few of the parameters, you can really help your vocal out. If you have any questions, please leave those in the comments below. And don't forget to download my Ultimate Logic Pro Starter Pack. This includes my Logic Pro Hotkey Cheat Sheet, my audio recording guide, my mixing guide, my gear guide, and my Logic Pro session templates. I hope you enjoyed the video, and we'll see you in the next one.